wife Jade. He's accused of masterminding her abduction and murder in April last year. But this case is also significant in legal circles, taking place in the country's first court to go fully digital for a trial.
A court like no other in the country. Laptops, projectors and screens. The benefits? A speedier trial with much less paperwork.
Well, this was the biggest one that we've set up in a court up to this stage. We've set up 8 television screens and one multimedia projector with a laptop that we've provided as well. So this is the biggest one that we've done so far. This technology was used in the SAPS environment in the Gqeberha case before, and it was used in various other court cases around the country that used this technology, but to a very limited scale.
The judge and even the accused have their own screen and microphones. The driving force behind the complete digital setup is Senior State Prosecutor Advocate Marius Stunder.
Since the beginning of this case, we can see the benefits because the system is actually very friendly, user-friendly, as you can see. There are screens in the court and you, the journalist, are having a good time there. And so far, we believe that it's really something that we could look forward to using, maybe in other courts. Of course, with resources allowing us to do that, but it's not something that we can implement now everywhere. It's a matter that we're trying to see how it works, but we believe that we are on the right track.
In the first week of the trial, court heard how there had been a number of aborted attempts on Jade Panayotu's life, her fight to stay alive when she was abducted, and her husband's long-time extramarital affair. More intimate details are expected to emerge this week. 8 weeks have been set aside for the trial. Janine Lee, SABC News, Port Elizabeth.